right. We're now joined by University of Houston defensive lineman, NFL prospect Logan Hall from Belton High School, joins us on Sikkim 365 Radio and 365 Sports. Logan, hey, thanks for your time. It has been quite the journey for you, from where you were when you arrived at Belton High School, even when you arrived at Houston, to where you are right now. How have you handled a lot of the attention that seems to be moving you up in the draft?
To be honest, I try to, you know, kind of tune it out. Obviously, some attention comes my way, and I have to acknowledge it, like this interview, but I just try and, you know, keep to myself and keep my eyes ahead and, you know, just keep working. Ultimately, that's the goal, to get better.
So, Logan, you're, what, sophomore, junior year, you're about 210, 215, right?
At Belton, yeah.
Yeah, at Belton. What are you now?
I weighed in today at 285.
Those damn McNuggets and McDonald burgers can do that to you, can't they, Logan?
That protein shakes, right, Logan?
Yeah.
Right. Now, believe it or not, it's, you know, salads and chicken breasts and rice, stuff like that. I try to stay away from the fast food.
Logan, how would you describe your development at Houston, and where do you feel your game got the best or improved the most over your time there at U of H, and who do you credit that for?
How would I describe my growth? You know, I've just grown in so many different aspects. I don't even know what to say. But as far as, like, what I've improved on the most, I would just say, you know, my attention to detail, for one, that's a big thing that I've improved on. My strength, I've gotten much stronger, you know, coming in since my freshman year. My preparation throughout the week, my pass rush, like, there's so many different things. I've just grown, you know, in my tape displays at my senior year, jumping my statistics. I credit all of that to, you know, my teammates, my brothers, Coach Early, the strength and conditioning staff. A lot of people are
when you that credit. You ran hurdles in high school, is that correct?
I did. Yeah, I was 110 and 300 hurdler.
There aren't many 6'5" or 6'7" guys who run the hurdles. That showed to me, obviously, and a lot of people, the athleticism, and I think blew some people away. How long had you been running, and what was that like? Because I would think that not many other guys were your height.
No, yeah, I was definitely the tallest one out there every time. I don't think I've ever encountered somebody taller than me. But I've been running hurdles since elementary school, probably fourth grade. And, you know, I did it all the way up until all throughout high school, except for maybe minus a year. But, yeah, I've been running hurdles for a long time, and I have, you know, quite a bit of success at it. So, but, yeah, it is kind of weird being a 6'6" hurdler.
A little bit different. What are pro scouts or whoever you're talking to telling you about what position you'll play? You've been on the defensive line, you've been inside, you look like you could be on the outside. I would think you'd be more on the edge, but what are they telling you?
So a lot of the conversations I've had, the guys were telling me that, you know, at the frame I'm at right now, you know, 280, I'd be an early down edge defender. So, you know, second down, stopping the run, and then, you know, coming inside as a sub rusher on passing downs. And they said that they see that kind of is my role where I'm at now, and they think I'd have a lot of success at it. But, you know, being that my frame is 6'6", I can put on as much as, you know, I'd say 310 pounds. I can get big, and my body can hold that weight well. So, three seconds where I live at is where I'm most comfortable at. So I told them, you know, if I could gain that weight and live inside the three, you know, I'm just as comfortable doing that. But ultimately, it's what they pay me to do. So.
Ed Oliver, Yeah. Ed Oliver, you know, came out of Houston, you know, obviously having a great career with the Bills. You now, what's the pipeline of the Houston Cougar defensive line and people starting to notice because of guys like Ed and you and others?
Yeah, it's just, they just make them different, man, in Texas. We're all Texas guys. Went to Houston, and, you know, we're just putting Houston on the map. The way we play down there, the way we're coached, it's just the culture, it's the mentality. And, you know, the D lineman there now, that, you know, there's going to be some guys coming out this next year, I believe, as well. So yeah, definitely the place to be is the D line, University of Houston.
So, Logan, Dana Holgorsen comes in last year, and it was a COVID year. Much like Dave Aranda here at Baylor, you can't really judge too much from COVID with just all that was going on. But you guys, you know, had a fine year. But, I mean, this year in comparison, obviously a massive jump up, and having everything kind of, I guess, more normal probably helped. But what was the key to having such a big turnaround in year number two? What was it like working with Dana Holgorsen, and why did it all work so well?
You know, I would definitely say chemistry. Being able to get back in the building, you know, get around the guys, get around the coaches, you know, actually eat together, not be masked up, you know, just have like real organic interactions and work, you know, without like all the COVID, the hindrances of COVID, you know. I would say that was definitely the recipe to success this year for us. Working with Dana, Dana's awesome. He did a great job. Great coach, love him. We got a great relationship. Can't say enough good things about him, but yeah, I would definitely say just being able to come together, that was the key factor.
Your parents retired military, your sister's a basketball star at Temple, your brother, older brother, ran track and cross country, so athleticism runs in the family. Who's the better athlete?
I think if you ask each one of us, we'd all give you different answers, but I think I'm the undisputed champ.
I think your sister's going to call you at any moment. But hey, Drew Pittman's your agent, and he got to know, I believe, your mother through his house being built. Is that correct? She's a part of the Chamber of Commerce in Salado. How did that all come about with you and him getting together as your agent?
Yeah, so it's funny. My mom actually met Drew, like you said, just through the Salado community. Because, you know, he's lived there and she works there. And, you know, she heard about him, you know, being an agent and representing athletes. So they started talking and whatnot. And then I had gotten into touch with him through her. And, you know, we talked for a little bit and hit it off. And it was just a wrap, man. That's all she wrote. He's done a great job for me. Got a lot of good things to say about Drew. He's awesome.
One of the things about Drew Pittman, he gets young men who are classy, character, all high character, all of that as well. His Drew's the son-in-law of Grant Taft. His wife Lane, of course, Grant Taft's daughter as well. One last thing: Houston's going to be in the Big 12 in the next couple of years. What did that mean, or what will that mean, do you think, to the program when that day comes?
Oh, that's huge! It's awesome making the jump. I'm really excited for that to happen. I think it means, you know, a whole lot to the university and to the city. You know, that gives us the opportunity to, you know, recruit bigger athletes, and it's just really exciting. You know, we got some new facilities being built, you know, centered around football and stuff like that. So I'm really excited to see that really happen.
Yeah, did you see that picture they put out for the new football facilities yesterday?
Yeah, I did. It was sweet.
Yeah, you kind of like, well, where was this when I was playing? It's kind of right. You do all the work, and then like the other guys get to enjoy it. But no, I mean, that's obviously something that you helped to build in a roundabout way.
Mm-hmm. Right. Yeah, I definitely did see that. I was like, man, you know. But you know, I'm happy. You know, the guys that come after me will get to enjoy that. It'll be a good year.
I know you got to get back to work. We appreciate it. Good luck with all what you have coming in front of you on whatever night it is, when the commissioner or whoever says, with the X pick in the draft, whatever franchise selects Logan Hall, defensive lineman, University of Houston, what will be running through your mind?
Just gratitude, you know. That's the relief, gratitude. Those are probably the number, the first things on my mind, you know. My mom, everybody that's helped me throughout the way, God, my family, my teammates, just gratitude, man. Because I couldn't have done any of it without them. I owe it all to them, you know, and just relief, you know.
Well, you've proven people wrong because you've gotten bigger, better, faster, stronger. Everyone kind of was intrigued with your athleticism, your height, and your frame. Thank you, Logan. Appreciate your time. We will be in touch and hopefully have you on after the draft. And good luck.
Absolutely, man. I appreciate your time.
Great to have you on. Sam Skidmore, now the AD at Belton. They have two schools, Lake and Belton. Gave me some nuggets on him. We appreciate. Also, Drew Pittman, who set us up as well, who's been a great fan along with Lane of this show. This is Sikkim, 365 Radio and 365 Sports. If you, what's two?